Welcome back, everybody, to another episode of our Fallout New Vegas playthrough. And in this one, we're going to be side-cutting a little bit and going over to the Boomers, going over to Fort Nellis and helping them out a little bit, seeing if we can first get there, and secondly, prove ourselves worthy. They don't trust us because we're an outsider, but guess what? We're going to make them love us, one way or another. Let's go!
Whoa there, pal. You better slow down, or you'll get blown up like the rest of the idiots who thought they'd scavenge in Boomer territory. Now that I've got your attention, might you be interested in a little information? It'll cost you, but it's well worth the investment. Whoa, simmer down. I'll tell you, I'm a gambler and a scavenger. I've made some cash from gambling and some cash from reclaiming goods that are no longer being used. Now, do you want my help or not? Oh, lordy, lordy. You haven't heard of the Boomers? What rock have you been living under? They're a bunch of artillery-slinging, grenade-lobbing odd jobs camping out in Nellis. Wander into their territory, and you're as good as mincemeat. There is a way, and I'll tell you. For a little wager. Well, I know the secret to get past. If you give me the caps, I'll tell you. If you make it back alive, I'll double your money. All right, I suppose I can cut you a deal, but not a cap lower. I gotta make a living here. Okay, here you go. That page has the details, but it's all in the timing as you move from building to building. I'll be here watching, so I'll know if you've made it to the gate or not. Remember, I'll pay double your wager if you make it back.
Welcome back to the Mr. New Vegas within my opinion, which I respect, the best-looking audience around. Somebody prove me wrong? I've got news for you. Merchants are saying that there's been little contact between traders from Nipton in recent days, causing concerns that the isolated town may be in trouble. Moving on. Scavengers report hulking individuals moving around Hidden Valley after dusk, but have been unable to identify them due to low visibility. Promotional consideration for this news program has been paid for by the Ultralux. The Ultralux. Live life in the lap of luxury. Ladies and gentlemen, this next song goes out from me to you.
Hold it right there. Don't you move. How the hell did you survive that bombardment? But I had you zeroed in the whole time. Nobody's that fast. Move a muscle now and I'll blow you to pieces. Then just stay where you are. Raquel will be here any second.
I'll take this from here. I'm Raquel, Master at Arms for the Nellis homeland. Mother Pearl, our eldest, wishes to speak to you. I oversee the security of the Nellis homeland, from the coordination of its defense to the training and fitness of its population. I wasn't the one firing the howitzers. If you want to see how good I am at killing savages, I can show you. Or you can accept Mother Pearl's invitation. It's your choice. Follow close and mind your behavior.
Welcome, child. Took your sweet time getting here, didn't you? I've been waiting a good 5 years for an outsider to come along and visit. Those howitzers of ours aren't just for entertainment, child. Explosive ordnance is what keeps the savages at a distance. Except you. There's something special about you, child, and it was the howitzers that gave you a chance to show it. Oh, so many ways. Small ones to begin with, so we can get used to what it's like to have a outsider around and about. Should that go well, it may be you can help in big ways, too. We'll have to see. You have to keep in mind that you're our first contact with the outside world since I was barely a woman. Seclusion has kept us safe, but the world around us is changing. Neon lights in the distance, patrolling robots, soldiers. My youngers think our guns can keep out the world. but I think we need to let it in just a little, or become its victim. You're that little bit of the world, child. Welcome to Nellis. You picked a good time to stop by, for we're swimming in problems. My youngers can tell you all about it. Raquel could use help with the bug problem. Doc Argyle has wounded he's tending to. And Loyal and Jack might be looking for help with some repairs. Or you could just go see Pete at the museum and hear the story of our people. All you have to do there is listen. Come and go as you like, help or don't help, I leave it up to you. But I hope you'll show my youngers that not every outsider needs to be blown up. How is your visit with us going, stranger? I haven't heard anything. You must not be trying hard enough. Later.
Mother Pearl's instructions are clear. You can move freely around Nellis, and artillery spotters have orders not to fire on you. These are extraordinary privileges. Don't abuse them. Long story short, the power failed a few days ago because giant ants have tunneled into the generator room and set up a nest. I led a team down to exterminate them, but there were so many of them. We lost. 2 killed, 3 wounded. Personally, I think it's more than a savage can handle. But if you want to kill those ants and switch the power back on, feel free. Sure, anyone can. But there's more than a few down there. See for yourself. One other thing. The ants must be eating gunpowder from the munitions down there, or something. They exploded when hit by a flamethrower. One of us was using a laser pistol. Same thing. Bullets seem okay. Just don't hit the artillery shells. Loyal's been working on some kind of weapon to use against them. Maybe you should check with him.
NCR officials at Camp McCarran were relieved when technical difficulties with its monorail line to the New Vegas Strip proved easy to fix. One anonymous official told us a serious mechanical failure would have been a disaster because of the age of the train and the scarcity of the replacement parts. Those were our top stories.
Keep your distance.
More classics coming right up for you, so stay tuned.
I hope Pearl knows what she's doing, letting you wander around Nellis as you please. If that's so, how about you look into repairing the solar arrays on the roof of the generator building? Nothing too complicated about it, but it's a long ways to walk my old bones, and there's been that ant problem over near there. You can't miss the array. It's on top of the generator building smack dab in the middle of Nellis between the two runways. Are you talking about that damn bright light we've seen blast off to the south occasionally? I was wondering what the hell that was. If they've got the parts, bring them on back. We need to get the array back up and charging. No. I started building a sonic emitter that might do the trick, but it's useless without knowing the exact frequency that would kill the ants. If you're willing to take the risk, be my guest. I've got it set to broadcast a powerful signal at 24,000 hertz. Just place it near their nest and cross your fingers. Signal's too high for people to hear, so no harm done. But it might make you feel sick to your stomach. What is it, outsider?
Evening.
What is it, outsider?
So you're the outsider. Lived your whole life out there, huh? Wow. I always thought you savages probably spoke a different language. But I hear you sound like us. Me? I work with Loyal. Mostly electronics work and robotics. Keeping the old technologies alive, right? Okay. What I could use is some scrap metal. It may not sound exciting, but around here we have to recycle every rivet and plate. The other thing, you being from the outside and all, well, I guess you'd call it a personal matter, but, well, forget it. That must be nice, sharing yourself like that, not being embarrassed or anything. Well, the thing is, there's this girl. Oh, you can't miss her. She has short red hair, and she's the most beautiful woman who ever lived. You'd really talk to her for me? What if she feels the same way? What if she comes here like you did? What if she gets blown up? What if she doesn't like me? Oh, geez. I better just let you handle it. I'm better with machines. They don't make my stomach queasy like this. That would be amazing. As in, I would thank you forever.
It was early in the morning when he rode into the town. He came riding from the south side, slowly looking all around. He's an outlaw, loose and running, came the whisper from each lip. And he's here to do some business with a big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. In this town there lived an outlaw by a name of
Once a Republican, always a Republican.
He was vicious and a killer, though a youth of 24. And the notches on his pistol numbered 119 more. Now the stranger started talking, made it plain to folks around. Was an Arizona ranger, wouldn't be too long in town. He came here to take an outlaw back alive or maybe dead. And he said it didn't matter, he was after Texas Red. After Texas Red. Was long before the story was relayed to Texas Red. But the outlaw didn't worry men that tried before were dead. 20 men had tried to take him, 20 men had made a slip. 21 would be the ranger with the big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. It was 20 past 11 when they walked out in the street. Folks were watching from the windows, everybody held their breath. They knew this handsome ranger was about to meet his death. About to meet his death. There was 40 feet between them when they stopped to make their play. And the swiftness of the ranger is still talked about today.
It was over in a moment, and the folks had gathered round. There before them lay the body of the outlaw on the ground. Oh, he might have gone on living, but he made one fatal slip when he tried to match the ranger with the big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. Big iron. When he tried to match the ranger with the big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip.
This is Mr. New Vegas fanning the flames of your passion. We've got some news for you coming right up. Refugees at Bitter Springs are giving startling accounts of the legate known as Lanius, who is said to be Caesar's top field commander. One refugee told us the legate took over an underperforming squad of troops by beating its commander to death in full view of everyone. The legate then ordered a tenth of his own force be killed by the other nine tenths. And you thought your boss was a pain. Also, merchants are saying that there's been little contact between traders from Nipton in recent days, causing concerns that the isolated town may be in trouble.
And can't run from me.
Ladies and gentlemen, this next song goes out from me to you.
Run from me!
But must admit the sleepless nights I've had about the boy. Hurry up,
Once, I still can't believe how you ran through that artillery barrage.
Prem, formally sworn in new sheriff today. RNV reporters were on hand to hear the new sheriff address the crowd.
People of Prim, the NCR wishes to...
I see the power's back on. The ants are all dead. Maybe Pearl is right about you, because I don't know how you pulled that off. I'll tell Loyal to send someone down to clear out the eggs and repair the generators. Good work.
Like luck tonight. Got a song for you now. It's about a guy who's cold on the exterior, but deep down, you know, he's a good man. And his name is Johnny Guitar.
Play it again, my Johnny. You can be kind, I know.
What is it, outsider? The next time you leave Nellis, keep an eye out for missiles. We're down to a 5-year supply for our launchers. Fine. How many? Thanks. Those'll last us a day. All right.
Once a Republican, always a Republican. Every day.
Johnny Guitar.
Hey there. Here's the rest of the payment I promised you back in Good Springs.
Johnny Guitar.
I'm getting ready to run a caravan up towards Utah. There's a town called New Canaan which is supposed to be pretty prosperous. The Crimson Caravan doesn't have any branches out that way, so it'll be up to me to get things started. It's a two-player game, and the winner takes the whole pot. You build a caravan using the cards in your deck. The goal is to create caravan bids that beat your opponent's bids, so there's more strategy than luck involved. It's why you won't see caravan in any casino. Too slow-paced, and more importantly, no house edge. Here, take this holotape. It goes into more specifics about the rules. You'll also need a deck, so take one of my spares. So... you feel like playing a game? All right. I'll see you around.
Mr. New Vegas. More classics coming right up for you, so stay tuned.
We can't sit idly while the Legion prepares their own elite forces.
You should go talk to Blake or Alice. They handle most of our contact with visitors. I watch all sorts of things with my binoculars. Who wants to know? And why? Nice-looking blonde boy? I always wondered if he was watching me back. What's he like? Really? Oh, that's so sweet. I'd love to go meet him. Is there any way the Boomers would let me visit Nellis? This is so exciting. Let me know how it turns out.
He's an outlaw loose and running, came the whisper from each lip, and he's here to do some business with a big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. In this town there lived an outlaw, was an Arizona ranger, wouldn't be too long in town. He came here to...
How is your visit with us going, stranger?
And he said it didn't matter, he was after Texas.
I may have heard a compliment or two, nothing special. Well, well, this is welcome news. Who is she? She's with those traitors? They've tried to contact us before, but I'm not interested in trading with greedy savages. This presents a bit of a problem. Jack isn't allowed to leave Nellis, and... I doubt she would make it through the artillery alive. I suppose Jack deserves a chance at love. You can tell Jack she has a free pass to enter, but he is responsible for her actions. Do not make me regret this decision, outsider. Don't get blown up. They knew this handsome ranger was about to meet his death. The big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. It was over in a moment and the folks had gathered round. There before them lay the body.
Have you seen her? The redhead of my dreams? She does? You mean it? That's incredible. What happens next? Can she come here? How do we make sure she doesn't get blown up? Should I talk to the gunners or to Pearl? Here, take this boomer outfit. I'll let the gunners know she's coming and not to shoot at her.
Once a Republican, all. What is it, outsider?
Hello again. How's your boomer friend? I was hoping you would. What's going on? Have they agreed to my safety yet? There's one more thing. I have a work contract with the Crimson Caravan, and if I walk away, I lose the wages they owe me. Could you do just one more thing for me and talk to Alice McLafferty about it? I know if I do it, she'll just say no. I'd hate to lose the money.
I've heard the Legion's planning to unleash their best men against us. Teach me
all that heart should know. Welcome to the Crimson Caravan Company, New Vegas branch. What may I do for you? As though there were no tomorrow. Oh, my darling. Ah, yes. Her infatuation with a boomer she's never met. It's a small camp. Word gets around. She's aware she's breaking her contract, which is undoubtedly why she sent you to talk to me instead of coming herself. Janet is free to leave, but she forfeits the wages she's owed. That's the price of contract breaking. Take it or leave it. Being sentimental is not how I made the Crimson Caravan so successful, but I'll allow it, just this once. Janet will be paid what she's owed. Consider it a gift.
Have you spoken with McLafferty yet? That's great! I can't believe you went through all this trouble for me. Thank you.
You should get out of...
Hi. I can't believe I'm going to meet my red-headed lady soon. I'm really nervous about it. Cool. How much can you spare? Thanks. Thanks for dropping it off. Anything else?
My face before you get yourself hurt.
Hi. I can't believe I'm going to meet my red-headed lady soon. I'm really nervous about it. Like I said, I can never get an...
Christmas compilation coming out soon. Nuclear Winter Wonderland. Look for it on holotape. All the latest news coming your way right now. Prim, formally sworn in new sheriff today. RNV reporters were on hand to hear the new sheriff address
the crowd.
I'm on
my way to meet that boomer you told
me
about.
People of Prim, the NCR wishes to inform you that you are under their jurisdiction now. And from now on, you're gonna be living by our rules.
Also in the headlines, tensions are brewing in Freeside between the ruling gang known as the Kings and the large number of NCR squatters seeking refuge there. The leader of the Kings, who would only identify himself as
Prim,
the King,
out and accepted
voices
NCR
displeasure
rule.
Calling NCR citizens, quote,
to feel
the
safe.
Devil in disguise. He added he didn't want to see the NCR in the ghetto and call for a mass, quote, return to sender. We'll have more news for you at the top of the hour. Here's B-B-B-Bing Crosby reminding us of those times when you absolutely have to kiss the person you love. Something's gotta give. Up next.
When an irresistible force such as you meets an old immovable object like me, you can bet just as sure as you're gonna get this. So I'm gone. Who knows what the fates have.
Thank you for getting Janet to Nellis. I've never been so happy in my entire life.
Mysterious sky.
See ya.
I'll try hard.